Today's question, how do you move a floating vehicle? Propulsion is a challenge for tube travel because the capsules don't actually touch anything. So how do you move something without touching it? That's right, Yoda, we just have to use the force, specifically magnetic force. This is called electromagnetic propulsion. It uses electricity to create magnetic fields that propel the vehicle. Now, if you're not exactly sure how electromagnetism works, here are some links to videos that explain it really well. Moving on, let's talk about the key components of a good propulsion system. First off, it should be efficient. This means that when you put energy into the system through electricity, a large percentage of that energy goes toward increasing the speed of your vehicle. The rest is lost, often as light, sound, or heat. Second, it should be capable of regenerative braking. This is similar to how a hybrid or electric car can recharge its battery while braking. Third and finally, the most important quality a propulsion system can have is reliability. Because when I'm hurtling through a tube at 700 miles per hour, I prefer not to crash. Most tube travel companies are currently looking at using linear induction motors, or LIM. LIM works by sweeping a magnetic field across a conductive plate. This induces an electric current in the plate with its own magnetic field. These fields interact to produce a force that propels the vehicle forward. There are several other ways to use electromagnetic propulsion that may be viable as well, but I won't get into the details. In terms of practicality, LIM is a highly developed technology since it was invented way back in 1840. Thanks, Charles Wheatstone! Now it's just a matter of developing the best possible LIM system for this application. In conclusion, the technology for tube travel is practical, but it just needs a little push. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time on Tube Travel.